Good morning, everyone. So in this blog, I'll just provide you with a couple of updates of things that have been on my mind in the last couple of months. Before I proceed, I want you to all notice my special t-shirt, Family Docs Rock, from the Alberta College of Family Physicians meeting where I was at last week. So the first thing is to give you a little bit of an update about the position evaluation and salary review at the National College that has been undertaken over the past year. And the purpose of this, again, is to ensure fair and standardized remuneration for all staff. First of all, I want to thank you all for your work in defining or looking at the position descriptions and being as accurate as you can with this. This has been very important. I also want to thank Teresa McGuire Garber and the staff team that has been working with her on this important project. The executive committee has realized what has been involved in doing this work and has been very appreciative. I want to say a few words about the salary review. There are many factors that enter into play when we look at salary review, and some of these factors include looking at salary benchmarks, as well as looking at scales of salaries. So when we've looked at this at the executive committee level, there has been a request for more information, and we are gathering this at this point in time. Our ultimate objective with this is to make sure that we pick what is good for the college, what is competitive in the market, and what enables us to achieve pay equity at the college. The second thing I'd like to talk to you about is the theme of member engagement. So this is a strategic theme for the college, and I've been reminded about the importance of this theme recently. Some of you may be aware that we are looking at designations related to certificates of added competence that we're going to be introducing, and we have received a chain letter from our members who have the EM designation, expressing some concern about potential changes to how their designation is reflected in the future. And they've expressed concern that perhaps they were not consulted about the planned changes. And what I've realized out of this is that, in fact, we did get feedback, we did consult members about the proposed changes, and probably assumed that this got percolated throughout the membership, when clearly, based on what we have received, this may not be the case. So this reminds me about the importance for us, under the team of member engagement, to really work better at facilitating the connection of members to one another, as well as thinking about how we communicate effectively to all of our members, as well as externally in general. There is a lot of work that's been done about this, but clearly there is more work that needs to be done. And I look forward to work with you in thinking through how we can do this better in going forward. So as usual, your feedback is welcome and will be taken into consideration. So these are those couple of reflections for this CEO blog. Have a good week, everyone, and I'll follow up in a little while with some additional pieces of communication.